Hey there, Kacey here. Today we're going to retorque the lug nuts on our Tesla Model X and refill the tires with the correct pressure.
We need a couple things. Some sockets. If you really just want the right size, a torque wrench. And a lug nut cup remover. In this case, we have the beautiful caps. A lot of the Teslas have either wheel covers or center caps, so we need the appropriate tool.
So let's get started.
You'll remove the caps. So just insert that there and release on the ground.
Like so.
Next, you'll need the right size socket. So for our Model X, it is a 21 millimeter. Then you'll need your torque wrench. Put the socket on it. So. Then you'll have to set the torque to the appropriate level. For Model S, Model X, and Model 3, and Model Y, that's 129 foot-pounds. Couple of newton meters here. So now we've got it set to 129 foot-pounds. What we're going to do is we're going to go to each lug, and we're going to just tighten it until it clicks. We're going to go in a star pattern, skipping every other lug until we come back to the one that we're missing. The reason we're going in a star pattern is to make sure the pressure is applied evenly. That one was really loose. Wow, this whole front wheel.
You do this within 50 to 100 miles of getting new wheels, tires, alignments, rotations, etc., as well as every couple thousand miles after that.
In the description below are links to all the equipment I use today, including the non-marking socket, the torque wrench, and the lug nut puller. So the next thing you'll do is you'll go ahead and put the caps back. And then while we're working with the wheels and tires, we might as well put the air back in them, so let's do that next. Before we do that, we can put our tools back. Remove the socket. This particular wrench needs to be stored at 10 pounds of pressure. So when you're done, untighten it, and then let it go. Turn it to 10.
this Milwaukee air pump is great. Battery operated, it's fast, even has a memory as far as to what setting you have it set to. Hopefully it's charged enough. Tire pressures for your Tesla are located on the placard for the car. Are located on the placard for the car. So on this car, they are 45 PSI front and rear. I don't actually run that pressure. I run it a little higher because I like a stiffer ride. And for my tires to last a little bit longer. So let's hook up this pump. First, we'll remove the dust cover, valve cover. If you want to keep your tire warranty, you don't ever want to exceed what's printed on the tire. In this case, it's 51 PSI. We're going to get 46.5. Again, you should probably only set this to what the manufacturer recommends. One thing I like about this particular pump is it has an auto off feature. So then to disconnect, I just hit this, and that's great. So again, we remove the dust cover. Can handle probably two or three good sessions. I usually take it back into the house and charge the battery after every session, just because it's part of my emergency toolkit. One more to go. Oh, I just got to turn that off. Now, if you're coming from a very low pressure to a very high pressure, say over 20 pounds per tire, this will get hot and it will time out for a little while. But that's good. It protects the battery, protects the pump, protects you. You'll feel this heating up as you use it on normal. taking care of my wheels and tires. Display the car is now at 45,730 miles. These are the tires that ship from the car. It is just now getting to the bare bars. On delivery, Tesla set this vehicle to always low. Well, I should say that back. When the car shipped to my delivery center, it was shipped in standard. Before I got the keys to drive off, the service center set this car to always low to minimize the shutter issue, which helped a lot. We've got 40 tires on the way, and depending on whose mobile service I get to come do the tires, either Tesla's or third party, we'll get the wheels mounted balanced, retorque them, repressure them. I've got another cool video for you coming. One thing to be mindful of when working with your tires is brake dust and rubber dust and road grime. They get everywhere, so you want to have some wipes or hand soap and water handy. This has been taking care of your tires and wheels on your Tesla. Over here are some videos on YouTube, please, you'll enjoy. And over here is the subscription bubble. If you hover over that and it says you're not subscribed, click subscribe for more content like this, where I show you how to maintain your Tesla, what it's like to own it, as far as software updates, supercharger reviews, road trips, and more. It's not just Teslas, it's other EVs as well, but we happen to own Tesla, so most of our content will be focused around that. And we'll catch you on the flip side.